I mean, in that last facility, I was not safe from the officers in that facility.
Do you have any comment about what was posted about you in the alleged Facebook group?
I mean, I think it's just it's just indicative of the violent culture that we saw on the inside as well.
I also asked her whether she would be asking for an investigation about this. She didn't answer that. Everyone went straight on in. Now, she did tweet about another facility that this group visited earlier today. I want to share that with you. She said, "Now I've seen the inside of these facilities. It's not just the kids. It's everyone. People drinking out of toilets, officers laughing in front of members of Congress. I brought it up to their superiors. They said officers are under stress and act out sometimes. No accountability." She also tweeted, "After I forced myself into a cell with women and began speaking to them, one of them described their treatment at the hands of officers as, quote, psychological wealth warfare, waking them at odd hours for no reason, calling them, expletive, tell me what about that is due to, quote, lack of funding."
I want to bring in Brian Hastings. He is the chief of operations for the U.S. Border Patrol. Brian, thank you so much for coming on. I got to get your response to all of this. Also, just keeping in mind that you're going to have a lot of critics wondering why it took ProPublica to publish this before hearing from you guys.
So we take all of the posts that were put out today very seriously. These do not represent the thoughts of the men and women of the U.S. Border Patrol. Each one of these allegations will be thoroughly investigated. We have already turned this into the Office of the Inspector General and our own internal CBP, Office of Internal Affairs, to begin the investigations.
Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez visiting one of these facilities. She says she didn't feel safe inside, even because of the agents. To her, you would say what?
Ma'am, we're professionals. We're dealing with a crisis right now. Over 680,000 apprehensions so far this year. Agents are under a great deal of stress, but with that, what I would remind the public is how many rescues the men and women of Border Patrol have done and put their life on the line to save various individuals throughout the year. Mm.
These agents, you well know, they are on this front line of this crisis, and you can imagine what some Americans are going to think when they read the reports about these offensive private posts. What do you want? What's your response to that? What do you want Americans to know?
So men and women of the Border Patrol are working very hard out there trying to protect the national security of America. It's very difficult to do right now when you're dedicating a large percentage of your workforce to dealing with the humanitarian crisis that's out there. And men and women of the Border Patrol are out there risking their lives every day to do the job right now. So don't let the actions of a few be representative of the whole, is what I would ask.
And I hear you say you're under a lot of stress. These agents are under a lot of stress. It's actually something that the Congresswoman said that the agents at the facility told her. But if once you go through, this process of investigation and you end up having to fire agents because of this, I mean, final question, you're already understaffed. How much would this impact you?
Well, the appropriate actions need to be taken regardless. We continue to do very well with recruiting. It's difficult recruiting with the crisis that we have at hand, but nonetheless, the appropriate actions will be taken in this case.
Brian Hastings, thank you so much for coming on and answering some of these questions, as this is just coming to us. Chief of Operations for the U.S. Border Patrol. Thank you.